हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सायखा परवीन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज नोट मेकिंग। वी मेक नोट्स व्हेन वी रीड अ टेक्स्ट बुक और अ रेफरेंस बुक, एन आर्टिकल, ए न्यूज़पेपर रिपोर्ट, ए जर्नल, ए पैसेज और वॉट एवर वी थिंक is important for us to remember to write an exam or to write a paper, research paper, let us say. Making notes involves collection of information, and for collection of this information, what do we have to do? We have to remember things, we have to collect information and we have to note it down. During note making, we need to take down important points, or the let us say main points of the passage which we have read. We write down only the important points which are going to help us to remember the information which we have read now at a later stage. So whenever you look at those points, you should be able to remember what you have read in that entire passage, in the entire article or in that entire essay. So this form of taking down notes, it depends upon the subject which we are studying. It could be any book, it could be an article or a magazine which presents us a very processed information. We read that information and according to our needs, we note down important points. And these important points will help us later for a quick and easy reference. So this condensed form of taking down those points is called note making. So what do we do in note making? We read an essay, a printed essay, a printed matter, and we note down the important points for reference later. And do you know what is the essential difference between note making and note taking? So what could be that essential difference? It is, you make notes when you read a passage. So whenever we read a passage and note down important points, it is called note making. On the other hand, when you listen to a lecture, when you listen to a speech and note down important points, so this happens in our classrooms. While listening to a lecture, we note down points. So that is called note taking. Even when a teacher wants to dictate you notes, what will the teacher say? Now take down notes. So while we listen to some matter and write down the important points, that is termed as note taking. But when we read a passage and write down important points, that is called note making. So note making involves reading skills, whereas note taking, it involves our listening skills. So that could be called the essential difference between note making and note taking. Now let us come to the essential components of note making. Essential components means what are the main aspects, what are the main features of note making. How do we make a good note? So the first among them is reading ability. What is reading ability? We need not only to understand but also to interpret what we have read, because sometimes we need to read between the lines. The literal meaning of a given line could be different, but the inherent meaning could be totally something else. So what should we do? We should read and grasp the essence of the text. We have to read it and we have to understand it, and we should also interpret it. Interpret it means we have to give the actual meaning which is intended by the writer, which is a bit difficult. And it involves your active reading. You should read the passage very actively. You should grasp the important points in the passage which we have read. And After reading the entire passage, after going through the entire material, you should be able to relate all those points. How is the first point related to the next one? How is the next point related to the last one? You should be able to give all these points a meaning. You should make them a coherent whole. And you should also have the ability to distinguish main points from other points, that is the points which are not so important. So what kind of points should we note down while we are making notes? We should note down only important points which will be necessary for us to remember the entire matter later. So you should avoid things which are not necessary for the context. Then the second important component is familiarizing oneself with the passage. This familiarizing oneself with the passage means you should read the passage twice or thrice unless and until you understand it. So don't start writing notes, don't make notes with just first reading. You have to read it even in your exam. When you get the passage for note making, what you do is you read it from the beginning to end. Try to understand what it is, and you get an initial idea of what the passage is about. And after that, what you do is you recall whatever you have read, and then you jot it down. It should be done only after second reading, at least second reading, so that you know which point is important, which point is relevant. Because in our first reading, we might think that the first paragraph is very important. We have got the entire information here. But as you proceed to read, what you find out that the actual information is contained, the essence of the passage, the essence of the text is contained in the last two or three lines. So we cannot decide before reading the entire thing. So you have to read it completely and then decide which point is important and which is not. So after you have selected that passage and after you have read it two or three times, what you should do is you should note down the important sentences. And even before writing the important sentences, you can sometimes also note down keywords. I'm not talking about making notes in the exam here, but sometimes when you are listening to something or when you are reading a passage and you are making notes, you can just note down a few keywords. You can have your own short forms also, so that, for example, let us say, I am reading Sherlock Holmes stories, let us say. So instead of writing again and again Sherlock Holmes, I will simply write SH, and I myself know that SH stands for Sherlock Holmes. Let us say I am reading a Harry Potter novel, so, and I want to make notes. So whenever I write HP, it means Harry Potter. So we can create our own short forms so that we can save our valuable time. Let us move on. So what is the importance of this note making? This is an art of writing. So how does it help us in improving our writing skills? So what are the key points which we are going to improve by making notes? So we can remember important details. So by making notes, we may not have that much time to go through the passage later. So when we just note down points, this is going to help us in exam. When you are preparing for exam, you make a note, you select a few keywords. Let us say you have an essay question in your core subjects. It could be physics, it could be economics, it could be history, it could be political science, or it could be any other core subject, chemistry. So what you do is, the answer is very long. It's an essay type question, essay answer. So what you do, you have understood the entire concept, and while learning the answer, while reading the answer, you underline a few keywords. If you remember those keywords when you go to write exam, you have to write exam, let us say tomorrow. So if you remember those keywords, then those keywords should make you write the entire thing. For the first paragraph, I will remember one keyword. So this is about the causes. I am writing an answer about the causes of French Revolution. So what are the causes of French Revolution? Or for that matter our sepoy mutiny. So what are the causes which led to sepoy mutiny? I will underline one or two words, and those words are going to help me in building up my answer in the examination hall. I need not remember the entire thing, so I will just remember a few words, causes, and about causes I'm going to write one entire page in the exam. Then what is the next word which I had remembered? It could be the course of the revolt. So course, how did it start, how, where did it start, how did it proceed, how did it let us say improved. So I will just remember the second word, course, that is my keyword, and I will build upon that keyword. Then what are the results, what is the reason for the failure of that revolt? So I will remember just few keywords which are going to ignite my imagination, ignite my memory, so that I can write the entire thing. So we have to remember only the important points, and then while writing those points, while elaborating upon those points, aa points ni manam eppudaithe elaborate chestunnamo, elaborate ga rastunnamo, detailed ga rastunnamo, then what should we do? You should organize your thoughts. Mana thoughts ni manamu clear ga organize cheskovali. So organizing your thoughts, then we have to refresh our memory. We have to recollect what are the details which we had read about this particular aspect. Manam ipudu ee aspect gurinchi aithe manam rastunnamo, ee keyword aithe mana mind lo ippudu undo, ee keyword ki, ee key idea ki aithe manamu ippudu develop chestunnamo. So what had I read about this earlier? Deeni gurinchi nenu mundu em chadivinanu? So we have to recollect, we have to refresh our memory about what we had already read in the past. Then we have to write a very good paragraph. It should reflect that you have prepared very well. Then let us come to the next slide. What are the features of a good notes? Features means what are the characteristics, what do we call a good notes? You have made a notes, you have read a passage and you have noted down a few points. So how can we say that these are the very significant points, these are the points which we expect from you? So those can be called the features, those can be called characteristics of a good notes. So it should be, first of all, it should be very brief. If you write it in a very elaborate way, what happens? It will be not different from the original matter which you had already read. Manam original edaithe chadivinamo, manam alantive sentences aa length e manam maintain chesthe, then what is the difference between notes and the actual essay? There will be no difference at all. So what should we do? We should make it very very brief, and for making brief we have to concise our ideas, and then we have to have only main points in the notes. And all these main points should, there are many points which are important, but how should we arrange? As I have already told you, our thoughts should be well organized. So these points which we are writing also, these points should also be arranged in a very logical order, and all these points, they are followed by sub points which I will tell you in a minute. And then we have, for each point what do? We separate it from the earlier points. Mundu rasina point nunchi manam deeniki koncham different ga separate ga rayali. How do we do that? We use some bullets. You have to differentiate between all these points. You use some bullets or arrow marks or asterisks, or you can give numbering. So all these points should be mentioned differently. And we should not write complete sentences, complex sentences. Be very very brief when you are writing these sentences, and we should avoid repetitions. We should not stress our points, that is called reinforcement. So when you have said a point once, okay, leave it there, don't repeat that point again and again by giving examples, by giving quotations, by giving references to examples, to quotations, to mana point ni manamu akkad prove chese avasaram ledhu. Just write the important point and leave it there. And the most important thing is, all these points, they should have one particular title. After you read the passage, యూ కమ్ టు నో అబౌట్ వాట్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్ ఈస్. దేని గురించి మనం ఈ ప్యాసేజ్ చదివినాము అనేది మీకు ఒక క్లియర్గా ఒక ఐడియా వచ్చి ఉంటుంది. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు రైట్ దట్ టాపిక్. ఆ టాపిక్ని మీరు ఫస్ట్ టైమే పైన రాసింటారు. దానికి రాయాలి. ఆ నోట్ మేకింగ్కి ఫస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ టాపిక్. అండ్ హౌ డూ యూ ఐడెంటిఫై ద టాపిక్? యూజువల్లీ ఏ టాపిక్ అపియర్స్ ఇన్ ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్. ఏదైనా మనం ఒక ప్యాసేజ్ పారాగ్రాఫ్ చదివినప్పుడు దానికి ఇంట్రొడక్టరీ సెంటెన్సెస్ ఉంటాయి, 2 or 3 sentences, ఫస్ట్ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ సెంటెన్సెస్, యూజువలీ ద ఫస్ట్ సెంటెన్స్ ఆర్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్ 2 or 3 sentences. ఆ 2-3 sentences మనకి ఏముంటుంది, ఒక టాపిక్ అనేది ఉంటుందమ్మా. దట్ ఈస్ ద టాపిక్. వీ కాల్ దట్ సెంటెన్స్ టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్. సో దిస్ టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఇట్ ప్రజెంట్స్ ద సెంట్రల్ థీమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్యాసేజ్, ద ఇస్సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్యాసేజ్. సో ఇట్ విల్ స్టేట్ వాట్ దట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్ ఇస్ అబౌట్. సో యూ రైట్ ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఫస్ట్, దెన్ ఆల్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్స్. మనం టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఫస్ట్ రాసింటాం కదా, అంటే ఒక టాపిక్ రాసింటాము కదా నోట్ మేకింగ్కి, తర్వాత మీరు రాసిన ప్రతి పాయింట్ ఏం చేయాలి, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు సపోర్ట్ ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్. సో మనం ఏమి ఎక్కడ దానికి డైగ్రెస్ అవ్వకూడదు, డైవర్ట్ అవ్వకూడదు. వీ షుడ్ నాట్ లీవ్ అస్ట్రే. మనం పక్కన వెళ్ళకూడదు ఆ టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ నుంచి. వాట్ ఎవర్ వీ రైట్ ఇట్ షుడ్ రివాల్వ్ అరౌండ్ దట్ మెయిన్ ఐడియా ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్. సో యూజువలీ ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఈస్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ టువర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్యాసేజ్. ఆ ప్యాసేజ్లో స్టార్టింగ్లోనే ఉంటుంది. సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్, అండ్ వెరీ రేర్లీ డూ వీ ఫైన్ ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఆర్ ద సెంట్రల్ థీమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్యాసేజ్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ and then write it first, and then it should be followed by all the sub points which support this topic sentence which we have identified. Then how to write good notes? The first thing which we have already said is we should avoid repeating. So once you have mentioned one point, let us be over with it. You have identified one key feature of that passage, of that central theme, you write that and just let us stop there. Don't repeat that point. Although I agree that the point is very important, but you need not go on repeating that point. And you have to avoid complex sentences. Sentences kuda complex ga very complicated structure lo raikunda, just write the notes in very simple sentences as much as possible. Try to use your own language. ఒక డిఫికల్ట్ వర్డ్స్ ఉంటే ఆ వర్డ్స్కి సింప్లిఫై చేసి దాని మీనింగ్ రాయవచ్చు మీరు. ఇఫ్ దెర్ ఈజ్ అ వర్డ్ విచ్ ఈస్ డిఫికల్ట్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్, సో వాట్ యూ క్యాన్ డూ ఈస్ యూ క్యాన్ రైట్ ఇట్స్ మీనింగ్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ లెట్ అస్ సే దెర్ ఈజ్ అ వర్డ్ కాల్డ్ యాంబిడెక్స్టరస్ వర్డ్ ఉంది. సో వాట్ యూ క్యాన్ డూ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ యూ నో ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద వర్డ్ వాట్ విల్ యూ రైట్? యూ విల్ రైట్ ద ఎబిలిటీ టు యూస్ బోత్ ద హ్యాండ్స్ అట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్. ఎ పర్సన్ హూ యూజెస్ బోత్ ద హ్యాండ్స్, who has the skill of using both hands with equal ability to ee two hands kuda use chese evar degareite manaki aa skill undo aa quality undo aa person ni manam em antamo ambidextrous antamo. So if you know the meaning of a particular word, what you do is you substitute the word with its meaning. Aa word ki meaning telisinappudu aa word raayakunda, specific meaning unde word raayakunda, what you do is you just write its meaning raayandi. Then try to use your own language as far as possible. Try to avoid copying the sentence from the notes. And then there will be some quotations. The author might have given some quotations. Author emi konni quotations ichintaru to support his ideas. We need not repeat the quotations. Then if the notes is given in first person narration lo okavela aa notes unte, the person who is writing the notes, he is using first person, I anedi, we anedi first person. So what we do is we substitute it with third person narration. And then after you write it, what should you do? You have to revise your notes, you have to reread your notes inkosari chudandi whether whatever I have రిటర్న్ ఇస్ కరెక్ట్. సో గో టు ద ప్యాసేజ్ అగైన్, ఇంకోసారి ఆ ప్యాసేజ్ చదవండి. ఏదైనా ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ నేను మిస్ అయినానా అనేది ఒకసారి కన్ఫర్మ్ చేసుకోండి. కన్ఫర్మ్ చేసుకున్న తర్వాత దెన్ యూ క్యాన్ డిసైడ్ దట్ ఎస్ వాట్ ఎవర్ పాయింట్స్ ఐ హ్యావ్ సెలెక్టెడ్ ఆర్ సఫిషియంట్ ఫార్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్ ఆర్ దిస్ నోట్ మేకింగ్. Then we come to the next slide, structure of the notes. Here all the main points have to be given some numbers, and what are those numbers? 1 2 3, you can write Roman numbers. Roman numbers lo manam 1 2 3 raivachu. Okay, so when making notes on passages, what should we do? We should divide them into main points and also sub points, and if there is necessity, avasaram unte daniki inka subdivisions kuda, further subdivisions kuda manam cheyavachu. Okay, so let us come to the structure. Just I have given here an example. The first is point number 1. Okay, ignore those bullets. I bullets kanipistunnayi kada, white abhi ignore cheyandi. What you see is 1, and after 1 here under 1, what do we write? We write the main point of the first paragraph. So ఓకే సింగల్ పారాగ్రాఫ్ ఇచ్చినారు అనుకోండి మీకు, సో వాట్ డూ యూ డూ, యూ డివైడ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్. ఆ సింగల్ పారాగ్రాఫ్కి మీరే ఏం చేసుకుంటారు, టూ పార్ట్స్లో మీరే డివైడ్ చేసుకోండి. ఆ ఫస్ట్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్ అంటే ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ అనుకోండి, సెకండ్ హాఫ్కి సెకండ్ పార్ట్ అనుకోండి. సో ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్లో వాట్ ఈస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సెంటెన్స్, ఆ నంబర్ 1 ఏదైతే ఉందో దాని పక్కన మీరేం చేస్తారు, మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సెంటెన్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ ఎస్సెన్స్, ద టాపిక్ సెంటెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్. ఆ ఫస్ట్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్కి ఏదైతే మెయిన్ పాయింట్ ఉందో ఆ మెయిన్ పాయింట్ని మీరు అక్కడ రాస్తారు. దాని తర్వాత ఏం చేస్తారు, ఏబిసి అని మూడు కనిపిస్తున్నాయి, సో అగైన్ దాంట్లో ఇంకా పాయింట్స్, ఇంకా కొంచెం ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఇవ్వాలనుకుంటున్నారు. సో యూ సపోర్ట్ దిస్ ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ బై రైటింగ్ అనదర్ 3 పాయింట్స్, అనదర్ ఒక 2 or 3 పాయింట్స్ రాస్తారు. ఈ పాయింట్ సిలో కూడా ఇంకా కొంచెం మీరు ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇవ్వాలనుకున్నారనుకోండి, సో యూ వాట్ డూ యూ రైట్, యూ డోంట్ రైట్ entire sentences, you just ee small 1 2 anevi numeric digits meeku ikkada kanipistunnayi. So here what you do is you will simply write those examples, or simply write 1 or 2 words which support this point C. So okka vela manam B ki support cheyalanukunte B tarvata ee 1 2 raaskuntam amma, C ki tarvata raayalanukunte C ki support cheyalanukunte C kinda ee 1 2 raastam. So here we end the entire matter which is related to the first part of the paragraph. Then we move on to the second part of the paragraph by writing this numeric digit 2. Ikkada 2 ani rasi manam second part of the paragraph ni rastunnamu. Ikkada manam em chestamu, the topic sentence of the second part. Aa second part lo most important thing em undi, what is the theme, what is the essence of the second paragraph. Idi ikkada manam em chestamu, ఈ సెకండ్ ఏదైతే నెంబర్ ఉందో ఈ సెకండ్ పాయింట్ ఇక్కడ మనము మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ అనేది రాసుకుంటాము. మళ్ళీ దీంట్లో సబ్ పాయింట్స్ ఏబి అనేవి సబ్ పాయింట్స్, దానికి సపోర్టింగ్ పాయింట్స్, ఈ మనం ఏదైతే మెయిన్ సెంటెన్స్ ఏదైతే రాసినామో సెకండ్ పార్ట్కి, ఆ సెకండ్ పార్ట్కి సపోర్టింగ్ సెంటెన్సెస్ మనం ఏబి అని రాస్తాము. ఈ బీకి ఇంకా మనం ఇంకా సబ్ డివిజన్ ఇంకా సబ్ సపోర్ట్ చేయాలనుకున్నప్పుడు అగైన్ వీ గో బ్యాక్ టు దోస్ స్మాల్ 1 2 రోమన్ నంబర్స్లో మనము సపోర్ట్ చేస్తాము. So here is the structure. So in our coming classes, what I will do is I will give you a few passages which you can read and practice for making notes. Okay, thank you.